My name is Anthony Peyton Young. I'm born and raised in Charleston, West Virginia. I identify, as a visual artist. I work primarily in painting, drawing, and ceramics, and sometimes papermaking. I come from a creative family, whether it be like altering a shirt or turning like some kind of scrap material into something else. So I felt like it really left me like always inspired to like make something or transform certain things. As I got older, my aunt and my mom had put me in private art lessons. I would say that in terms of my work, I do look a lot of painting and drawing. A lot of the inspiration comes from my family, Black culture, Black aesthetics, Black spiritual traditions. Thinking of like certain trash or things that we discard or scrap materials and transforming those, taking something and making something from that nothing. A lot of the works that I've been doing and more recently, it's been like a lot of bleaching, thinking of bleaching as a tool of erasure of Black narratives, or like a tool of white supremacy, something that's branded or ingrained into us. I think racism is something that is like ingrained into our culture. It's something that is very much a part of West Virginia, whether we want to acknowledge that or not. For me, that has been the reality that I felt. So my work tends to express a lot of those things. In West Virginia, for me, I don't always tend to see as much diversity, like as many like artists of color, at least artists who look like me. As one of the few, I hope that it will encourage more Black and brown artists within the West Virginia area to push for an artistic career. And I think as an artist of color, you have to be around other people who come from diverse communities for your work to be understood. I think it's really important to be really serious about your craft and trying to make the best work, and also thinking critically about the work, being able to talk about the artwork, being able to talk about the inspiration that comes from it and what you're trying to articulate in this body of work. I know being an artist is a really tough career as well. So I think like things like the Tamarack Foundation, it really allows people to see a possibility of where they could possibly further themselves. It's a really nice fellowship in the sense that it like, gives you like a really nice stipend to like kind of help with like production of your work and also other things in your artistic practice. I think for me to be a fellow, it allows me to see other people who've chosen to stay in the West Virginia area and see how they have found an arts community for them or found a way to incorporate their artistic practice in their everyday life. Networking in a broader sense beyond just like thinking of like connecting with people, but really trying to build like long-lasting relationships, because I think that's the most important part. Building long-lasting relationships with people who aren't necessarily always in your area also. With West Virginia, I feel like there's a lot of really genuine people here. Thinking in a more political sense, I don't think that it really always cares as much about the people who actually make it a good place. A lot of the times it really lacks in diversity, and I think honestly, if you're gonna have any kind of creative space, diversity is a huge component of that. And diversity goes a lot broader than just having Black and brown and other like people from different backgrounds, but it's like having different perspectives and having perspectives that are broader and that want to see radical change. And I think truly for West Virginia to become like a better place, it needs to have all those things incorporated too.